Hey there, Frailers. Well, this song's a little bit trickier than some of the ones I've been doing recently, so I hope you're up for a challenge. But before we get started, I just wanted to thank everybody who's commented on the previous ones, and especially people who have subscribed. And if you haven't yet subscribed, then please do. Please subscribe and click the little bell so you'll know when new videos come out. And thanks very much. Let's get started. Here I stand, head in hand, turn my face to the wall. If she's gone, I can't go on, feeling 2 foot small. Everywhere people stare, each and every day, I can see them laugh at me, and I hear them say, hey, you got to hide your love away. Hey, you got to hide your love away. How can I even try? I can never win. Hearing them, seeing them in the state I'm in. How can she say to me, love will find a way? Gather around all you clowns, let me hear you say, hey, you got to hide your love away. Hey, you got to hide your love away. To another Beatles song, and as I said, this is a little trickier because this is in 3/4 time, and this is the first song I've done in my reviving of the Frailing Folk Song of the Week, the first 3/4 time song, waltz time, as they say, and just to go over how the Frailing strum differs for waltz time. If you remember, regular 4/4 time Frailing strum is, so it's a strike, a strum, and a thumb. 3/4 time is a little different. It's actually, in last week's video, I spoke about double thumbing a little bit. This is very similar to that. So it's, strike, strum, thumb, thumb, thumb. Strike, strum, thumb, strum, thumb. You can also do just strike, strum, thumb. Strike, strike, strum. So it's like strike, strike, thumb. Depends on the song. If you like the sound of it, just doing a second note. Or if you want to do it as a strum. So that's what I'm doing pretty much the whole way through there. So it starts out on G. So it's here, and it goes to D, stand. And it goes to F, head in hand, back to G, and then to C. Turn my face to the, so it's two. And then it goes to F again, one, and back to C. If she's, that's G, D. If she's gone, I'm back to F. I can go back to G. And goes to C. Feeling 2 foot small. F to C to D. Now, I also spoke a little bit about suspended chords last time. And last time I was talking about the C suspended chord. And that was on my last video, which is on, I still haven't found what I'm looking for. This is actually a D suspended chord. So what you're doing is you're actually stretching your little finger up to play here, which is actually the same as the fifth string G. But I like to do it this way, so it's like that. And if you can't do it, you can just stay on the D. And it goes back to the second verse, which is everywhere. So that's G to D. F to G. Each and each. And every day. So it's C, F, C. I can, that's G again. C them. Back to D, back to F. Laugh and meet me. But open G. Back to C. And I hear them say. So that's F, C. And it goes to the D. Now you can do a couple of things here. You can do that suspended. Let's try it again. The suspended chord again. The other thing you can do is, if you're very familiar with the song, you know that there's a descending bass line that kind of goes. So you can do it either way. You can just stick with the. And it goes into hey, so that's on an open G. So that's a hey, you. And I do a single note here. So you strike down on the third string, second fret, or open actually, and then finger it at the second string, and then the open second string. Hey, you got the. High to C, love A. Now this is the really tricky part. It goes, starts with that suspended D. So you're going to stretch your little finger all the way up. And then it goes to just a regular D. And then a D second, I think it's called. So what you're doing is you're suddenly going from being here, where you're playing the D with the first finger on the third string at the second fret, the second finger on the second string at the third fret, and then the little finger. And if you prefer, you can do it. My hands aren't that big, so I usually do it this way. But if your hands are big enough and you want to do it, play your D this way with your third finger here and then stretch up, you can do that. I prefer to do it with the pinky and then just slide it like that, but it's up to you. I also have a sore third finger, so that kind of helps too. Anyway, and then so it's. And then what you're doing, I'm doing at least, is I'm dropping and I'm barring across here, so I'm catching the first string at the second fret with, so I'm barring right here across these three strings, and then fingering here. So it's. And then back to the regular D. Now, for any of you who play guitar as well, you'll see that what you're really, you're fingering there, you're doing it. what would be fingered a D chord on the guitar, but on the banjo, it's actually, I think, a D second, but... And then it goes back to, hey, you got to hide your love away. Now again, that's completely optional. If that's just too difficult for you to do, then you don't have to. You can just do a straight D. Hey, you got to hide your love away. Then it goes back into the verses again. How can I, G to D, how can I, back to F, even try to G. I can, that's a C, never, to F, back to C. Hearing, that's a G, hearing them, back to F, seeing to G, them in the pain I'm in. That's F to C, back to D. How can she say to me? So that's that G, D, F, G, C, back to F, back to C. Gather round, so G, D, F, G, C, F, C, and then it goes back to that. Hey, you got to hide your love away. Hey, you got to hide your love away. Oops. And then you kind of vamp and play the play another verse of the chorus again, just as an instrumental. And that's the whole song. And certainly if you haven't played much in the way of three-quarter time yet on the banjo, that's definitely something to work on. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one. Anyway, just as a reminder, again, I really appreciate people who comment and subscribe and click the bell, but I also have a Patreon page, if you become a patron, you will get, in addition to getting early access to these videos, generally these videos are released to the patrons about a week before they're placed up on YouTube. But you also get a lyrics and chord PDF that I will send to you as a patron. And you get personal thanks and a shout out from me on my next video. And then you also really help because you're encouraging me to keep doing this and helping to support and sustain the series, the Frailing Folk Song of the Week. So anyway, if you do enjoy these, then I would encourage you to become a patron. Thank you very much. You guys take care.